It's our main event of ONE Championship, Heart of the Lion. Bibiano Fernandes, Kevin Belingon for the Bantamweight Championship of the World. Michael Chavello, Mitch Chilsomithia, Belingon in the red, Fernandes in the black. It may very well be the raw power of Belingon, the finesse and technique of Bibiano Fernandes.
You see Kevin throwing that lead hook. That's how he sets up that spinning kick. He's looking for the spin early. Bibiano testing the leg right there.
We saw the turning back kick to the liver of Andrew Leone. One of the most spectacular kicks we've ever seen. It sent Leone a full 10 feet across the ring on that night. Was the beginning of the end for Leone. And there it is from Belingon. Turning back kick to the liver.
That's one to the body already.
Jab from Belingon, outside fight kick from Bibiano, looking to drop down for a single leg there, the Brazilian. Belingon saying he received a groin strike, and a moment's break here called by referee Olivier Cox.
You can hear the
certainly the aggressive start though from Kevin Belingon here, Mitch. He's turning early, he's trying to line up the power salvos.
He said he wanted to attack the body. This is the exchange. Bibiano went low right there as he was attempting an inside leg kick. He immediately went back up, a flurry of punches. He was looking for the takedown. Takedown wasn't there. It came over the top, but he did tap the groin.
Just a caution there from our referee, Olivia Ghost. Accidental groin strike, of course, but you hit the groin and the pain receptors kick in. So a moment to recover here for Kevin Belingon, who's already showing his hand very early on in this world title match. We can see the game plan here of Kevin, as you said, to go to the body of Bibiano Fernandes. They believe that's the weakness. They believe that's the chink in the armor of Bibiano Fernandes.
This is how he likes to set up, right there to the low, right there. No denying that it happened. You can almost hear the crack of the groin right there. But Bibiano shakes it off, being the toe that he is, ready to put in work.
They recommence here in the first round of action. Look for the body work again from Belingon, the man with the flowing mullet. Fernandes, the bantamweight champion, the greatest champion in ONE history. Never beaten here in ONE.
Bibiano's got that reach advantage. Let's see him throw out that jab, start testing the distance.
Oh, he just put Bibi on the jaw with that short left hand. Bibi dropping low levels to try and lock onto it. Leg to take down Belingon. Belingon does not want to go to the ground with Fernandes. Fernandes, double leg here, trying to get the Filipino down. Belingon not going there, however. Body shot from Belingon.
This would be a good first test for Kevin Belingon's takedown defense. He looked stellar against Martin Nguyen in the takedown defense, but Bibiano is a different breed of grappler. Look at him attacking the legs. Look at Kevin. Good defense so far. He's got to be careful. That's where you want to go.
Inside of half guard here. Bibi Fernandes, top position, peppering palm strikes to the side of the head of Kevin Belingon. Now Belingon finds himself in Bibi land. How does he defend against the several submission attempts and the ground and pound that Bibi can bring from these positions?
First thing he needs to do is take that right arm and start looking for an underhook. In half guard position, if he can get an underhook underneath the left arm of Bibiano, he's going to be able to turn onto his side. Now he's got the arms trapped on the other side, so he's got the half guard on the other side. That's what he needs to start doing. He needs to get one side on the underhook, because right now he's got his half guard on the left leg of Bibiano and the underhook on the other side, the right side of Bibiano. So he's kind of trapped himself in this position. Bibiano can apply pressure with his shoulder and look to pass the guard. Kevin needs to create movement in this space. It doesn't want to give Bibiano the opportunity to start setting things up.
Fernandes, a BJJ sensation, five-time world champion, three-time Pan American champion, has won 11 gold medals in elite BJJ competitions around the world. It's been an aggressive start from Bibi.
Don't run the fence, guys.
Fernandes has a proven gas tank. He's gone five rounds, five times in his career, winning all five times by decision.
No technique on the escape right there. Pure explosion to get out of the half guard there of Bibiano Fernandes.
Resets here, this Belingon. A has power in the legs. Oh, turning back kick to the liver. And there's one to the head. He tries to take his head off the headache maker from Belingon. He's put the power rule. And Fernandez looked a little shocked momentarily, especially the spinning hook kick to the head. There's another turning back kick to the liver.
He was right. They are definitely going after the body with that spinning back kick. And look how fast he comes out of that. There's almost no setup. He's not even throwing that hook. It's just an explosion into that turning back kick.
The liver, a very large organ in the upper right portion of the abdomen, highly vascular area. A shot to the liver can be excruciatingly painful.
First and left in the first round.
Martial articles say the most painful way to get knocked out is with a liver shot. Turning back into the liver again there from Belingon. It's about the size of a football, the liver, right side of the body. Mostly protected by the rib cage, but still slightly exposed. And if you dig in between the 9th and 10th rib, you hit that vagus nerve, it can close down the entire body. That's what Belingon's looking to do with his turning back kick. There's one from Bibiano Fernandes. My word, what a start here from Kevin Belingon. He went straight to the game plan. He showed his hand. There's the new VP, Misha Tate. There's Mighty Mouse, Demetrius Johnson. So many luminaries here, Cape Side, in Singapore, for ONE Championship.
And this is what they're watching. That spinning back kick landed, not close to the liver, but up top a little bit. That one was hunting again after it. He is repeatedly going after that. But that up top kick was a beautiful spinning heel kick. Caught Bibiano high on the guard, veteran that he is, caught that kick.
Okay, Mitch, play coach for a moment. If your team look high, what are you telling Kevin Belingon to do?
Kevin Belingon is putting things together beautifully right now. Their game plan is working to the T. I'd like to see Kevin Belingon set that up a little bit, throw the jab, get him thinking about the hands first. Get Bibiano lift his hands up, then spin to the attack to the body. Bibiano, he's got to move forward. He's a little bit tentative there in the last couple, about 90 seconds of that first round. He started to slow down a bit. He was watching careful to the body.
Ready?
Likes to Bibiano throw the hands and start to chain wrestle with him. Back Kevin up against the cage and take him down and grind on him.
Singapore has been a happy hunting ground for Bibiano Fernandes. It was here in 2013 that he won the title. Well, to unify the ONE Bantamweight World title by Betty Sutil Kim. Oh, good right hand, stiffly there from Belingon. Bibi tries to thread the right hook, turning back into the liver. Bibi backs it up with the right hand. Double leg now from the Brazilian. Gets the takedown, and we're back in Bibi land. The half guard position. Let's see what Fernandes can do. The takedown has come early in the second round.
And we were set up with the hands. He was able to utilize the boxing, back Kevin up with a big right hand, get him up against the cage, and now he's grinding on him. Now Bibiano's going to start to slowly and methodically work on Kevin. He's got to slow him down a little bit. He's got to get Kevin to expend some energy. Kevin is extremely explosive. That's how he got out of the first exchange here on the ground. He was able to just throw Bibi off on him.
Let's go, guys.
The explosion, the fast twitch muscle fiber of Kevin Belingon is at an all-time high. Bibiano needs to slow him down.
It's got to serve well mentally for Kevin Belingon that he's out of the first round. Last time they met in 2016, Bibiano tapped out Belingon with a Kimura in just 4 minutes and 4 seconds. Here he is in the second round, and Belingon told us, I'm a completely different martial arts machine than I was last time we fought.
Every single one of Team Nakai always excels in the rematch. They go back, they've got their head coach who breaks everything down, and they always find a way to be much more successful in the second time around.
Fans.
When they run it back, Team Nakai, second team.
Now we're on 19 and 5, 11 finishes, including 8 knockouts, 9 of those in the very first round. Scramble here. Going on back to his feet. Seems to be overwhelming Filipino support for Kevin Belingon in the crowd here in Singapore tonight.
And again, he exploded out of the technique.
And the chants go up for Kevin Belingon, the underdog here in Singapore. Spinning back to Bibi Avanger, tries to loop in the tag, and Belingon gets out of the way. What a matchup for the Bantamweight Championship of the World. It's one championship, Heart of the Lion, live from the Singapore Indoor Stadium. Got the right hand cocked and ready here, Belingon. Shifts off to his left. Bibi did center of the cage. Jab there from Fernandez. Belingon taking his time. Very patient match so far from Belingon. Overhand right misses.
Everything Kevin throws is full force. There's no waiting out process, no setup. Everything is just one big shot, trying to take that head off of Bibiano Fernandez. But good eyes from the veteran. He's moving out well. And so Kevin is extending.
Oh, my word! He got ample on that! Jump turning back kick to the belly button of Bibiano Fernandez. He must have been half a foot off the ground, Nick. That was incredible.
You hear the crash from that side kick.
Tight down there from Fernandez. Now the Brazilian, up the intensity, up the aggression, takes the back of Belingon. Here's Bibiano. This is what Fernandez does so well. The body triangle locked on. And Belingon's got no place to go. Belingon could be in trouble here. Bibiano goes for the arm. Can he find the finish?
Kevin Belingon pushed the leg off of Bibiano. A straight escape through the arm off, or through the leg off rather, saved the arm. But Bibiano still can't even accept the arm off. Bibiano is covered up. A lot of this is coming off. Those landed right there, though. Bibiano's laughing. He's okay.
Have a look at Belingon. It's a bounce-down in Singapore.
Bibiano still attacking off his back. Threw up an armbar attempt right there. Now he's got the high guard. Look for him to go for a triangle. He's got one arm trapped there on the side. That's it. To let it go. He's still got the arm trapped. Looking for the armbar.
Belingon gets up some shots. That's two rounds down. This one is an absolute scorcher.
Kevin, he survived the back. Look at Bibi. Look at the way he's trapped that right left arm. Throws the leg over. Look at Kevin. Get off me. Get that leg off me. He's okay. I'm okay. Get that leg off. Bibiano covers back up. Still has that arm trapped. Look how he traps the arm with his leg. Hooks in like he's doing a hamstring curl. Completely has the arm trapped. Uses his right arm to attempt it again. Goes after it again. Kevin shrugs him off. Gets on top and drops the ground and pound. What a second round, Michael Ciavella.
Kevin Belingon, more escapes than Michael Schofield in that round. And what have we got in store for you in the third? It's an absolute barn burner. Belingon first to emerge from his stall. Third round of five. We are heading towards that deep water. Bibiano's been there many times before. And this sellout crowd here in Singapore, loving every moment of a truly epic main event. Let's see if Belingon goes back to that river with the turning Wushu back kick. Belingon began his martial arts career in Wushu. He was awarded a Wushu scholarship to the University of Encordilleras. Led his move to Bacchiao City. And then, of course, joined the great team Lagai. Here's a Philippines national Wushu champion. And we've been seeing some of that Wushu striking. Belingon just falling short with that right hand. Overhand right there.
Let's go, Kevin.
Here's the turning back into the midsection, trying to put the belly button through the back. Bibi measuring with the jab, resets now. Good right hand lead there from Fernandez.
The reach of Bibiano is, that's what makes him so effective on the stand-up. He just utilizes that reach so very well. You can see Kevin throws big, wide, looping shots. And you can see how his elbows are nice and flared. That leaves a hole right through the middle. Bibiano's trying to exemplify, he's trying to exploit it, but Kevin is throwing everything with still 100% power.
His main sparring and training partner, Mighty Mouse Demetrius Johnson here, cage side. Bibiano Fernandes going for title defense number 10. Mighty Mouse has had 11 of them. Two amazing, complete martial arts warriors. Bibiano Fernandes finding himself right now in the match of his life. The crowd in Singapore against him. Kevin Belingon has brought the heat from the opening battle. But we saw the flash of Bibiano. The flash of the flash Fernandes in the second round when he came agonizingly close to taking home Kevin's arm.
Very close, but Kevin came just as close to going with the body. Those shots are going to start to pay dividends later in the match. Going to start to wear down Bibiano. Bibiano is not as fast as slow, but he's still landing with these shots.
Exquisite jab, two from Bibiano, left to go from Belingon. 2 minutes 40 remains, third round is five. The Philippines versus Brazil. Oh, almost caught him with the counter right hand there. And a snappy jab from Belingon. But Bibiano had the right idea. When Belingon commits that turning back into the liver and he misses the target, the follow, the counter right hand could come smack bang on the kiss.
And where have we seen that before?
To Newman, give it to Edward Filayan.
That could be the answer to that little riddle right there. Edward showing his hand. He says, I'm going to spin. Bibiano has got to circle out to the side and land that hand over right hand.
Mitch, at any point here, do you feel the Belingon is going to the well one time too many, hunting after that turning back into the liver, that it may become predictable and Bibi may start to purely time off it?
I mean, he's probably up near the double digits in attempting that spin kick. Bibiano's seen it, but he's got to avoid it. He can't take it over and over again. He's going to start to wear on him. And Kevin is throwing everything with full power. So you can see Kevin starting to slow down too. And this is his crowd.
Here, going to get a 1 minute 40 remains, 35. Watching out the legs here for Fernandes.
Interesting. Bibiano could have went into side control, but he chose to shove the legs between his legs, trap him, and slowly try to work his way into mount.
Let's go, guys. Work.
A tremendous contest. Right in front of our Chinese commentary team across the country. Top position, Kevin Belingon. Hope you're enjoying your folks. In 138 countries, they're live and free on the ONE Super App as Bibi Fernandes mounts Kevin Belingon.
And Belingon's got 45 seconds here. He's got to hold on tight to those arms, but now they're starting to be sweating, so Bibiano slid the arm out. Now he's going to go. Look how he has that left arm there. He's nice and high. Kevin's got to pull him tight. It's a bad spot to be in, though. This sets up an armbar. Watch his knees. If he chooses to go high, oh, he goes flat.
To finish.
Applies the pressure there. Now he's going to... I think this is a ground and pound position right now.
20 seconds remains. Third round.
That's the veteran right there, Bibiano. He knows that they're slippery right now, so Kevin could pull out of an armbar. So he chose to go heavy hits and soften him up and end the round in a very dominant position.
Postures up now, Fernandes tries to drop the anvils on the head of Belingon. Snakes in the right hand, three down, two to go.
That's a veteran move right there. He chose to not risk losing the position by going after the armbar. He flattened his hips out, softened Kevin up a little bit, went high right as the bell was about to ring, and just let the punches come down. And that, we don't go round by round. We go by the match in its entirety. But that is a great way to end 15 minutes right there, Mr. Schiavello.
Star-studded team LeGon in the corner of Kevin Belingon. The landslide, Edward Filayan, who in a few weeks' time in Manila will take on Amir Khan for the World Lightweight Championship. Then Bibiano Fernandes. We know he's seen it all before.
Fast and hard.
You think that Fernandes underestimated Belingon at all, Mitch?
No, I don't think so. I think he's seen the past six matches. I think he's seen the improvements that Kevin's made, but he's also extremely confident in himself, and he knows the type of martial artist that he is, the type of athlete that he is, and also the type of strategist that he is. Everything that he's doing is very methodical at this point. These are the championship rounds. This is where Bibiano lives and breathes.
Let's go, guys.
The penultimate round. Jabbed in from Belignon. Jabbed from Bibiano Fernandes. Spinning heel kick from Belignon. Hang close. Try to bring the heel to the temple. Cutting Wushu side kick to the knee there. The common Belignon move just above the knee. Jabbed from Belignon to put down the points. Fernandes jab two, didn't have the stops behind it though.
And he's still landing on Kevin. And that's what's giving him a little bit of just success in the stand-up, is he's still landing with these shots. And what that's gonna do, it's gonna create an opening for him to just like that, throw that overhand right, change levels, and go after those legs.
Two absolute warriors who have overcome a lot of adversity early on in life. Fernandes almost dying from malaria, contracted in the Amazon jungle where he was fending for himself and hunting and gathering as a seven-year-old. Belignon had to go through some loss of family members, raiding of bandits in his childhood home in the Philippines, up to poverty. And here they are, both men, in the main event at the top of the martial arts world. He won championship here in Singapore.
Up to finish.
Jumped over the half guard there, landed inside control. Kevin starts to look a little bit fatigued. This is not something we're used to seeing. That's that explosion that we're talking about. You can't explode out of like that. You have to make sure you're technical. You still got to maintain that technique, especially with a grappler like Bibiano Fernandes.
Once again, we are in the deep theater. As I said earlier, Fernandes, five times in his career, has gone the full five rounds on all of those decisions.
Work to finish.
Doesn't look like Belignon's gas tank is slowing at all, even though he is the older statesman here. Side control for the Brazilian. 2 minutes 35 remaining, fourth of five. The Bantamweight Championship of the World. Oh, elbow to the top of the head there from Belignon, trying to open up a cut perhaps. Cuts in the hip a little here from side control, does Fernandes. The media attention surrounding this main event all week here in Singapore. It's been extraordinary. So many photographers and reporters from newspaper, radio, television, websites. Some groundbreaking news released in ONE Championship this week.
Let's go, work to finish.
And we are seeing a fitting main event. Looks for the full mouth as Fernandes slips out the back. He tries to take the arm. And once again, Belignon is free. And this crowd loves it. Another escape from Belignon.
Hard to finish an arm bar this late in the match. They're so slippery, easy for them to pull out. But Bibiano, once he gets a hold of that arm, he can stay tight with it. But Kevin is still so explosive, he's able to just power out of these shots, or these attempts at submissions.
125 on the clock now. Bibiano's gotten Belignon to deep water. You see that the aggressive striking, it's not fair as it was in the opening two rounds from Belignon. It's still dangerous as ever. Is it demoralizing, Mitch, that Bibby's trying to dump past and not securing them?
Not so much. I don't think he's demoralized. I think he's trying to figure out another solution. You could see him inside the side control, and he didn't want to give it up, but he's trying to finish. Bibiano is not the lay and pray. He's not going to stay there and just hold the position. He's going to try to finish you. He loves to finish his opponents, and he's always going to be looking for it. He made that as a calculated risk. It didn't pay off, but that's Bibiano Fernandes for you.
Fernandes controlling sense of undefeated since 2010, Bibiano Fernandes. And what great runs he's putting along the way. Antonio Banuelos, Yoshiro Maeda, Koichi Okazaki, Sutro Kim, Ueda, Daehwan Kim, Tony Taru, Chris McCullough. Back to his feet. There's damage on the bridge of the nose of Bibi Fernandes. Another top thumping right hand into the round. We're going into the fifth and final. This is crazy.
That's the power of the silencer. Out of nowhere, the tide can change. He put Bibiano on his backside with that beautiful right hand. Look at Bibiano, measuring, calculating, right through the middle with the right hand. Watch Kevin Belingon using that power to slip his way out. The BJJ World Champion goes after the submission, has the armbar deep. Look at Kevin, no, not today. This is my moment to shine. Beautifully done, but what does Kevin still have? He still has that power in his right hand. The thunder in the right hand can be delivered at any moment. He's still dangerous. Still, even though he's tired, even though he's exhausted, he still has that one-hitter critter, Michael.
Fifth and final round. 99% of pundits did not think it would get this far. But here we are, inside the sold-out Singapore Indoor Stadium for the Bantamweight Championship of the World. Who will prevail? They touch gloves. Outside leg kick from Fernandes, the champion. Outside leg kick again. What tremendous heart. What aggression, what power from the interim champion, Kevin Belingon. Turning back kick to the liver from Belingon. All right, Mitch, with 4:30 remaining, what does Belingon need to do?
He's gonna have to land big. He's attacking that leg beautifully. See how Bibiano's limping a little bit on that leg? I think these things are starting to build up for him. But what's he doing? He's setting up that spinning back kick. He's gonna keep going to the well. He's gonna keep looking for that power. What it's gonna do is gonna get Bibiano to drop his elbows down to his body to protect the body shot. What's that gonna do? That's gonna open up the head. Kevin Belingon can still come over the top with a beautiful right hand. Bibiano needs to work the jab. Needs to work the jab, set up that right hand, and look for the takedown. Put Kevin on his back and grind on him for the next 4 minutes. But he's got to get at least 2 minutes on the ground in a dominant position.
Time is ticking down. Fernandes sends a cut. Inside leg kick to the right hand. Good combination, Fernandes. Jab there from Belingon. Belingon looks for the outside lead leg. Can't find it. Lots of swelling around the brow of Kevin Belingon. Damage to the bridge of the nose of Bibiano Fernandes. High kick from Belingon. Fernandes saw that one coming. Jump turning back kick. Bon Jovi style. Shot to the heart. Bibi resets. Will one of these two men put their foot down and go for it? Throw caution to the wind. Hell for leather with 3 minutes remaining. Is it time to pull out all the stops? Leg kick there from Belingon and goes to the inside thigh.
Michael, at 20 minutes, I had Bibiano slightly ahead, even though he was knocked down by that right hand. But at this point, Kevin is starting to inch forward. He's starting to land these strikes. He's starting to outstrike Bibiano Fernandes. He's starting to connect more.
You wonder if with his experience, Bibiano may be trying to go kleptomaniac and steal him in the final minute or so. Jab from Belingon. This one's close. There's no doubt about it. It could turn any moment.
This is an extremely close match. I think it might come down to the last 2 minutes. Either way, right now Kevin's starting to find his rhythm. He's starting to land shots. Bibiano found his right home for that right hand just now.
Inside leg kick from Belingon, nice and high on that inside thigh.
There's a scoring, Michael. That's like the fifth one that's landed this round.
Belingon has been putting down the score with the striking here in the fifth. Bibi's got to change it up now. Got to go for something, either the strikes or look for that takedown. Jabs from both men.
I think he needs a takedown. He doesn't want to stand here with Kevin lighting him up. That's what he goes after. Oh, Kevin gets away from Bibiano Fernandez. Can he do that for another 90 seconds and keep on his feet? Keep going after that low inside leg kick.
Hitting Belingon, man who likes to raise chickens. Looked like a greased chicken as he escaped Bibiano Fernandez moments ago. Chance going up to Belingon. Big outside guy kick from Fernandez. There's 1 minute 10 remaining for the Bantamweight Championship of the World. Leg kick again from Belingon. No doubt he's won the strike in this final round. Jab from Bibiano. What does Fernandez have left? He tries to catch him, but it's not catching Chris Lightning.
He's got to set that up better. He's got to throw those hands. He's got to get Kevin lifting up his hands to protect the head and then shooting for the takedown. Nice leg kick.
Kevin throws a leg kick with a right hand from Belingon. Threads the jab, does Bibiano Fernandez. Under 40 seconds now. Leg kicks again from Belingon.
30 seconds left.
This is Belingon's world, man.
And the target prep from Belingon. On the back foot and out striking Fernandez. Fernandez has come forward. Belingon misses with a little kick. 15 seconds now. Is there one big salvo left in their Hail Mary shot? Final 10 seconds. This place going crazy. Belingon puts a fist in the air. He believes he's won it.
Michael Cibello, what back and forth action. Every round was razor close. So many different variables go into judging this matchup. The striking superiority of Kevin Belingon, the shots landed by Bibiano Fernandez, the top control, the submission attempts. What an amazing unification bout between two world-class martial artists, two Bantamweight World Champions. Who is gonna leave Singapore with the strap? Michael Cibello.
Chatri Sinchitong, the founder of ONE Championship, to present the belt to the winner. Will it be Kevin Belingon? Will it be Bibiano Fernandez? Wherever you're watching live in 138 countries, live and free on the ONE Super app, how do you score it? Belingon claim his 20th career victory. Does Fernandez get his 23rd? Does Belingon stop the streak of Fernandez, the winning streak that dates back to 2011? Here we go.
Ladies and gentlemen, after five rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. Judge number one calls this bout in favor of the red corner. Judge number two scores this bout in favor of the blue corner. And judge number three calls this bout in favor of your winner by split decision. And now, the undisputed ONE Bantamweight Champion of the World, Kevin Belingon!
It's history made! Kevin Belingon, the Bantamweight Champion of the World! The rain of gold over the cage here in Singapore! And gold's gonna go over the shoulder of Kevin Belingon! Unbelievable scenes! The first man to beat Bibiano Fernandez in ONE Championship. The first man to beat him since 2010. And that was the man to do it. Came out of virtually nowhere in the last 18 months. And his rise, his tear, his streak, phenomenal. It's a fairy tale scene. A dream comes true.